Hey everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you how to select objects in your image using the improved Object Selection tool in Photoshop 2022, along with its new feature called Object Finder that lets you select objects just by hovering over them. I'll cover everything that's new with the Object Selection tool in Photoshop 2022, but I'll also cover the old ways of using it from previous versions, which we still use today. To learn more about Photoshop, be sure to subscribe, and let's get started. I'll be using this image that I downloaded from Adobe Stock. The Object Selection tool is found in the toolbar, and if you click and hold on its icon, you'll see that it's nested in with the Quick Selection tool and the Magic Wand tool. I'll choose the Object Selection tool from the list. Before we look at what's new with the Object Selection tool in Photoshop 2022, let's start with a quick look at how the tool was used in previous versions. The reason is that we can still use it like this today, and there are lots of times when we need to, especially when it comes to fixing problems with the selection. So in previous versions, we would start by going up to the Options bar and setting the tool's mode to either Rectangle or Lasso, depending on whether we wanted to draw a rectangular selection outline or a freeform selection outline around the object. I'll choose Rectangle, which is the default setting. Then to select an object, or in this case, a person, we would drag out a selection outline around them. When you released your mouse button, Photoshop would analyze the image inside the selected area and would then redraw the selection around the object that it found. To add a second object to the same selection, we would press and hold the Shift key on the keyboard and drag a selection outline around the object or person we wanted to add. And to subtract an object from the selection, we would press and hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac and drag around them. We could keep adding objects or people to the selection by holding the Shift key and dragging around them. But notice when I add the guy on the right to the selection, that Photoshop missed the bag on the side. To fix that, I'll hold my Shift key to add to the existing selection, and I'll drag around the missing area. And when I release my mouse button, Photoshop reanalyzes that part of the image and adds the bag to the selection. Now, depending on the shape of the object, it might be easier to draw a freeform selection outline rather than a rectangle. So let's say I want to subtract the bag from the selection. I'll go back to the Options bar and I'll change the tool's mode from Rectangle to Lasso. Then I'll hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac and I'll drag just a rough selection outline around the bag, making sure to surround it without needing to be precise. I'll release my mouse button and the bag is removed. And that's how the Object Selection tool worked in previous versions of Photoshop. But there's now an even faster way to select objects in 2022 thanks to a new feature called Object Finder. I'll remove my current selection outline by going up to the Select menu and choosing Deselect. Object Finder is found in the Options bar and is turned on by default. It uses Adobe's artificial intelligence known as Adobe Sensei to analyze the entire image looking for objects that we can select. And you may notice, right after you choose the Object Selection tool, that the refresh icon next to Object Finder is spinning. This means that Photoshop is analyzing the image, looking for objects, and you'll want to wait until it stops spinning to let Photoshop finish what it's doing. The Object Finder will refresh automatically anytime you make a change to the image, but you can click the icon yourself to refresh it manually. If you don't want the Object Finder to refresh automatically, then click the gear icon and change the Object Finder mode from Auto Refresh to Manual Refresh. And then it will only refresh when you click the icon yourself. But usually, Auto Refresh works best. To see the objects that Photoshop found, click the new Show All Objects icon. And the objects appear highlighted with a blue overlay. So with my image, Photoshop was able to detect all five people as objects that can be selected. If you find the blue color hard to see, click the gear icon, and in the overlay options, you can choose a different color. You can also change the opacity of the overlay from the default of 65%. And if you would rather see the overlay as an outline around the objects instead of in front of them, you can enter a size value into the outline box. I'll increase it to 2 pixels. And if I turn Show All Objects back on, the objects are now highlighted with an outline or border around them. But I like the standard overlay better, so I'll click again on the gear icon and I'll set the outline back to 0 pixels. I'll click Show All Objects again, and now we're back to the overlay in front. And just a quick tip, you can toggle Show All Objects on and off from your keyboard. Press and hold the letter N to turn it on, and then release N to turn it off. If releasing N doesn't work, just press it again. So with Show All Objects turned on, we're seeing a preview of all the objects in the image that the Object Finder detected. But nothing is actually selected yet. To select one of the objects, first turn Show All Objects off. Then hover your cursor over an object, and the overlay will appear over just that one object. So as I move across the image, each object is highlighted separately. To select the highlighted object, all we need to do is click on it. I'll click on the guy on the left, and Photoshop instantly draws a selection outline around him. You can then move your cursor away from the object to hide the overlay and view the selection outline itself. To add a second object or person to the same selection, hover your cursor over them to highlight them, then press and hold the Shift key on your keyboard and click. I'll add a third person as well by hovering over them, holding Shift, and clicking. To subtract an object or person from the selection, hover over them to highlight them, then press and hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac and click. And if you want to deselect everything at once and start over with a new selection, simply click on a different object to select it. I'll click on the guy in the center to select him and deselect everyone else. So as we've seen, the Object Finder in Photoshop 2022 can make selecting objects in an image easier than ever. The problem is, it doesn't always work perfectly. Notice that even though the Object Finder did a good job overall at detecting the guy himself, it missed part of the book he's holding in his hand. And if I try to add the book to the selection by holding Shift and clicking on it, nothing happens because the Object Finder doesn't see it as an object. But earlier, we covered how the Object Selection Tool used to work in previous versions of Photoshop, where we needed to drag around objects to select them. And we can use those same methods in Photoshop 2022 to fix problems when the Object Finder makes a mistake. To add a missing area, first go up to the Options bar and set the tool's mode to either Rectangle or Lasso. I'll change it back to Rectangle. Then press and hold the Shift key on your keyboard to add to the existing selection and drag around the missing area. Release your mouse button and the missing area is added. If Photoshop missed a spot like it did here, then simply hold Shift and drag around it to clean things up. I'll add a couple more people back to the selection by hovering over them, holding Shift, and clicking. But now watch what happens if I try to subtract the guy in the center by holding the Alt key or the Option key and clicking. Photoshop again missed that same part of the book, this time leaving it selected. To remove it manually, I'll hold Alt or Option on a Mac and I'll drag around it. And now the guy and the book have been removed. But what if the Object Selection Tool just can't figure out what it is we're trying to subtract, no matter how many times we drag around it? Well, there's one more option in the Options bar that can help us out. I'll clear my current selection by clicking on an empty part of the background. Then I'll select the woman on the left by hovering over her and clicking. And notice that Photoshop included the notebook she's holding as part of the selection. But let's say I want to subtract the notebooks. If you go back to the options bar and click the gear icon, you'll find an option at the top called Object Subtract, which is turned on by default. Object Subtract is what allows the Object Selection tool to automatically detect objects that we want to remove from the selection when we hold the Alt or Option key and drag around them. It's basically the opposite of how the Object Selection tool normally works. Instead of finding objects to add to the selection, it looks for objects to remove. I'll leave Object Subtract turned on for the moment, and I'll press and hold the Alt or Option key, and I'll drag around the top part of the notebooks to subtract them. And Photoshop detects the notebooks and removes them as expected. Then I'll do the same thing with the bottom part below her arm. And again, the notebook is detected and removed. But that's because Object Subtract was turned on. So I'll undo those steps and add the notebooks back to the selection by pressing Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac a couple of times. Then I'll go back to the gear icon, and this time I'll turn Object Subtract off. And now, if I try to subtract the notebooks by holding Alt or Option and dragging around them, this time, Photoshop does not try to detect any objects within the selected area. Instead, it uses my selection outline itself as the area to subtract. I'll do the same thing with the bottom part of the notebook. And again, Photoshop subtracts everything inside my selection. So turning Object Subtract off removes any intelligence that the Object Selection tool had, at least when it comes to subtracting objects, and instead it acts like a standard selection tool. So why then would you ever want to turn Object Subtract off? Well, for the most part, you'll want to leave it on. But for times when Photoshop is having trouble detecting the area you're trying to remove, you can turn Object Subtract off. Then set the tool mode to lasso. Zoom in on the area if you need to. And then hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac and manually draw a precise selection around the exact object or area you need to remove. Now, drawing a precise selection with the lasso tool can be a real challenge. So I'll press Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac to undo my selection. And here's how to switch from the lasso tool to the much easier polygonal lasso tool, so you can select areas just by clicking around them. First, since we want to subtract from the selection, press and hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac. Then with the key held down, click and hold your mouse button to start the selection with the lasso tool. Keep your mouse button held down, but release the Alt or Option key. Then press and hold the Alt or Option key again and release your mouse button. It's a bit confusing at first, but if you did it right, you'll switch from the lasso tool to the polygonal lasso tool. Then just keep the Alt or Option key held down and click around the area to draw your selection as a series of straight lines. And once you've made your way back to the starting point, release the Alt or Option key to complete the selection. I'll do the same thing with the bottom part of the notebook. I'll hold the Alt or Option key and I'll click and hold my mouse button to start with the lasso tool. Then with my mouse button still down, I'll release Alt or Option. And then I'll hold Alt or Option again, and I'll release my mouse button. And now that I've switched to the polygonal lasso tool, I'll click around the area to select it. I'll release my Alt or Option key to complete the selection. And now both parts of the notebooks have been removed. Now, since you won't always need to subtract an area manually like this, make sure to go back to the gear icon when you're done and turn Object Subtract back on. Once you have your object selected, you'll usually need to refine the selection and clean up any rough edges by switching over to Photoshop's Select and Mask workspace. But since Select and Mask is a whole other topic, I'll cover it in a separate video. Instead, I'm going to use the Object Selection tool to help me create a quick selective color effect. I want to select two of the people in my image, leave them in color, and turn the rest of the image to black and white. So I'll start by clicking on the woman on the left to select her. Then I'll add the woman on the right by holding my Shift key and clicking. So I now have the two people selected. But what I really need is to have everything except for them selected, which means I need to invert my selection. To do that, I'll go up to the Select menu and I'll choose Inverse. And we can see by the selection outline around the edges that the selection is inverted. I'll add a black and white adjustment layer by going up to the Layer menu, choosing New Adjustment Layer, and then Black and White. I'll click OK to close the New Layer dialog box, and Photoshop instantly converts the selection to black and white, while leaving the two people I initially selected in color. And just to quickly see what happened, if we look in the Layers panel, we see that Photoshop added a black and white adjustment layer above my image, which means that the image and the effect are separate from each other. And the Layer Mask Preview thumbnail shows us that Photoshop converted my selection into a layer mask. The white part of the mask is the area that was selected and where the adjustment layer is affecting the image. And the black part is the area that was not selected and remains in color. And there we have it. That's how to select objects in your image using the Object Selection tool and the new Object Finder in Photoshop 2022. Let me know in the comments if you've used the Object Finder and what you think of it. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel to learn more about Photoshop. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.